Hello. So, if you saw in the last video, you'll see that this car was painted. Next video, we're going to be removing all the masking paper, tape. So, let's get started. Before we do, take a look at this. I just can't get over this. This is crazy. Look at that. It's better than seeing the wheel look nice and OEM. Instead of having overspray on it. Merry Christmas. Dude, I am in love. This thing definitely got sprayed on. Look at that. But oh well, doesn't look too bad. Okay. Looking like a normal car. Oh my goodness. Sorry if I'm being like annoying, but dude, I'm so hyped. It looks so cool. Nice. Okay, so I don't think you guys understand, but I went through a lot of cans. I have 13 cans right here. When I painted this door in this rear quarter, I was freaking out because I only had 2 cans left. And for like the thing that I didn't care about, like the bottom of the bumper, I had to use like these very empty cans. And I had to like shake them in order to use all the juice. All these cans are like dead empty. Even these two almost have nothing. I just had the right amount and I was freaking out because if I didn't have enough, that could have been bad. So the thing about this paint, it's awesome, you know? It's gloss, can handle outdoors, pretty strong, can last for a while. But if this paint dries up and you spray that, it'll wrinkle up and it'll look crappy. Only reason I know, I've had this happen in the past and it sucks. My calculations were pretty exact. I was about to buy 12. Good thing I added one more. Never mind, I found an extra can. I actually went through 14 cans. Wow. So if you're painting a Miata and you're doing it very carefully, 14 is the amount you want. But if I were you, I'd buy probably 18 to be safe. This is so goofy to me. Let's continue unmasking. These should be satisfying. Oh yeah, look at all that red still. I don't think you guys want to see me unmasking because I think it's pretty boring. So, there you go. Looks pretty cool. Now this, let's see if we got anything on the mirror. No overspray, let's go. Yeah. Mirror came out better than I thought, honestly. Now this side. Look at all that overspray. I put a bunch of newspaper, so like no overspray would get on the soft top. Because last time I painted a rear quarter and stuff, the soft top still had a little bit of overspray. So this time, there should be none. I put tape on everything. Newspaper on newspaper. Oh God, might come out F1P. This should be very satisfying. This nice little strip. Nice. All right, this is coming out weird. Come on, one piece. There you go. That's the money shot. Oh, spoke too soon. We got a little bit of overspray here, but not too bad. Dude, look at all these layers. I put so much. I probably didn't have to do this because there's so much dust. The paint probably wouldn't stick on it. What do you think about that combo? Red and blue. This is so satisfying. Hope you guys are enjoying this as much as I am. This unmasking is so cool. Oh, look at that. Right, so I gotta be careful. The paint is still like fresh. It's still on the drying process. I can still scratch it. Oh my goodness, it's so nice. Take all this off. I think I filmed enough. So, this is gonna be off. Okay, I gotta film this part. This is already off, but this, I know it's gonna be so nice. Oh, yeah. This is so good. That's a pretty solid line. Now this, Sweet. Let's see if I did a good job masking this mirror. Awesome. This should come out beautifully. I'll make a little hole right here. Oh, yeah. If this isn't satisfying, I don't know what is. Ooh. Oop. I'm gonna try to finesse it. Never mind, I don't wanna do something dumb and mess it up. Got a little eager and did this one. Hell yeah. Let's open up the door and see how it came out in here. Oh, gotta fix that. Ooh, look at that matching. That's how it's supposed to be done. Now it doesn't look weird when you open the door, you know? I am honestly so damn happy with this. Oh, and I can take off this. Not freaking bad. Oh, and then this. So damn good. Mm-hmm. Now. Heck of good. Seriously freaking happy with this. Last bit. There you go. All the tape is out. Well, I left this. I'm being lazy. I got most of it out. It's all red from when I was sanding it. So doors are basically done. Came out pretty damn good. Next is the trunk. So happy this is all blue and matching. But there you go. Only part that I could get paint on is this. This happened when I was painting here. I kind of didn't match this much. But oh well, that's okay. It's under the trunk. If I just actually tried and did that. Only ugly thing about this trunk, I shoved stuff in here, but if you look, these are separated. It's supposed to be welded on or put on like that. And since it's not attached, it makes the trunk very flimsy. So it pops in and out a lot. I put body fill in, I don't want it to crack. So, shoved some stuff on it so it wouldn't bend over. Next up, these guys. These might be a little annoying. Boom. Boink. Next is this little guy. Dude, it smells like freaking gas in here. Probably because there's no cap. But okay, that's pretty damn good. Oh. Can't forget that. And loving memories of the red. Honestly, I like the red because it looks like a little warning to only put premium. All right, let's complete it. So dusty. Doesn't match for shit, but there you go. Blue, blue, blue. Next is the windshield. Boop. I'm not gonna film it. Here you go. Magic. Boop. Man, I love my Christmas gift. Windshield is free. Look at that. Damn. Next thing to do, we're gonna clean off all this nasty dust. So, let's get a rag and get to work. Found some wipes. So I cleaned off all the dust. With all the wipes, now I can get the microfiber and clean it very good. And just like that, cleaned up. It's not really red and dusty. Come out pretty damn good. Forgot that little guy. Next thing we can do is start putting on the taillights and everything back together. Look at that. Freaking awesome. And I even got the center brake light in. She's looking like a damn car again. It's got a little bit dusty, so let's clean up a little bit. Gas cap came out pretty damn good. Hostage. Beautiful. No overspray. I'm stoked there's no red on here. And this, that stuff will get covered up. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. That's amazing. Still a little bit red. Kind of lean and icy. Now, same thing here. So damn happy with that. Putting on the front markers and turn signal, you know. All the lights are in, they look good. Oh yeah. I don't know if I want to have these bulbs in or the OEM ones. I'm kind of a sucker to have like a stock looking Miata. So there's the look for now. Next thing I can do is start putting on the emblem. These bad boys. Let's put them in. In here, we have a new lip. So let's remove the wrapping. There you go. So we got a rear lip, but I think this rear lip looks freaking sick. It just makes it look cleaner, you know? I will not be painting this because every time I painted something like this, it just peels off because like there's some sort of oil on it. And I'll just leave it alone. From factory, these are not normally painted. So let's put it on. Here's with no lip. It's not bad. It's so clean under here. And like, it has some different flavor. This car is so clean, dude. It's like no rust on it. If you're doing this, there's already a hole there, there. And that's what I love about this. Since this is an OEM thing, they already mark it for you. So you see that? See those dots? Well, you're drilling right in the center. So there's five dots, and then you're drilling the center. That's awesome. It's all along here, and they match perfectly well with all those holes. So drill it out and put it in. And look what I just found out. The sway bar, racing beat, not bad. But I hate this exhaust. So damn loud. I'm pretty sure it's an ISR, but ah. So what you're supposed to do is probably put a self-tapper in here. This came with self-tappers, or these wood screws, but it'll be hard as crap to put them on here, you know? So what I did was, I just put zip ties. Zip ties are really strong. These will not come off. This is sturdy. Trust it. And boom. Lip is on. A little tricky to tell right now, but it looks so freaking good. It just adds a little bit of aero. And the last piece of aero, the front lip. So this one is actually kind of painted marina blue. I don't know if it's a real one. It's not too far off, but I'm gonna be painting it black. As you can see, it has a couple of scuffs and stuff. Looks pretty ugly. So I'm gonna sand it and paint it black. He's a little ugly before. Hello, one day later. Front lip is painted, looks glossy and quite nice. Look at that. It ain't perfect, but dude, it looks pretty damn good. It's a front lip, so it's gonna be scraped on and stuff. Can't complain. And dude, check out the rear lip. It looks so damn good. You guys have no idea. This car's coming along too freaking good. I love this so much. But yeah, see? The lip and the bottom makes a pretty good difference. Here's another car. So I got some vice grips to hold it in place. And then I put some self-tappers. So, self-tapper and zip ties all the way around. This corner was a pain, but dude, I'm so eager to see this. But let's get the other side done. And just like that, the front lip is in. It only took a couple of zip ties and self-tappers. Oh yeah. The necessities you need to put on a front lip. Couple of zip ties, self-tappers, impact, grill, dykes, and vice grips. Just like that, the front lip is on. Dude, it looks so damn good. It just cleans it up a lot. Now the front looks just like what it's supposed to be. But man, this car came out freaking beautiful. So we unmasked all the masking paper, masking tape. We cleaned up all the red dust on the soft top and the glass. Put on all the lights, all the plastic trims. We got the beautiful front lip on. Tail lights are in, emblems are on, and the bottom lip is installed. Enjoy the edit.